Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at using Google Calendar with your Mac and your iOS devices. So when I get a question about Google Calendar, it's usually about how to sync a Google Calendar with an iCloud calendar, which doesn't make any sense because you see they're both cloud calendars. You can access both using any of your Mac or iOS devices. There's no need to sync across from one to the other. You just use one or the other. So for instance, here I am in the Calendar app on my Mac. And I'm going to go ahead and add a new account. Now one of the types of accounts I can add is a Google account. And then I enter my Google email address, usually a Gmail address, and password. And then here it'll give me an account summary of the calendar information. And you can see in this case I'm adding a calendar, so it's not going to give me the option to add mail or notes. If I were to go to System Preferences and add this Google account, then I could actually add it as a mail account for the Mail app as well as a Notes account for the Notes app. But in this case, I'm just going to stick with it as just a calendar. And here you can see now I've got, in addition to my iCloud calendar, I've got a Google calendar. And if I close it and go back here, you can see I had an event I created in this calendar for lunch today, and you can see it instantly appears here. Now, I'm going to create another event, so let's create it for tomorrow, and let's create a meeting, and you'll see this will sync across when I sign up for this calendar in iOS. So I can see here in iOS, I'm going to go in, this is in the Settings app, go to Mail, Contacts, and Calendars, and I'm going to add an account here. Then I'm going to select a Gmail account and add the same account. So you can see now I've got selections here. Since I'm in the Settings app, I can have Mail and Notes. I'm going to turn those off because I'm just going to use this Google account for calendars here. And then I'm going to hit Save. And once I do that, then I'll be able to, I can see it's added there. So now if I go to the Calendar app here, I can see that under Calendars, I've got it listed there as the Gmail calendar in addition to my other ones. And I can see I've got that lunch for today. I also have that all-day meeting for tomorrow. So this is very useful for sharing calendar between two or more people, say you and your spouse or you in a work group. You can set up a Google account just to hold this calendar, and everybody can have the password to it and have it as one of the accounts they have on their device. Now Google Calendars are outside of Apple's ecosystem, so that means in addition to working on Macs and on iOS, they also work on Android phones, on Windows PCs, anything that has a client that could take a standard cloud-based calendar. So this is useful for just one person if, say, you have an Android phone and a Mac, or say you have an iPhone and a Windows PC, and you want to stick with using Calendar client apps. You don't want to use iCloud's web-based interface on the device that doesn't have a client that can handle iCloud. So you can use it for that. And most importantly, the thing I'm trying to get across is there's never a reason to have to sync a Google Calendar with an iCloud calendar. If you're going to use a Google Calendar because, say, you want compatibility to non-Apple devices, then just use the Google Calendar. It works great on all Apple devices, and there's no reason to use an iCloud calendar. So you can still use iCloud for email. You can still have an iCloud calendar that's your own, and you could just use a separate Google Calendar for the things you need to use that one for. So I hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. And go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.